So I'm just giving you an overview here. If you're coming to the park and you want to see this, the Boca Negra portion of this 17-mile park is the area where you'll find this particular petroglyph. And there's only two parking areas in the Boca Negra, and it's the first one you come to after going through the gate. And you'll come through this little visitor center right there, little rest area. And as you're headed up, it's this first big boulder off to the left-hand side. Come to the back of it, and you will see.
Judson YouTube video he put up, and he found this particular petroglyph, which resembles a dinosaur. You can see the, it's coming off his neck. I don't know what else that could be, but on tail.
Speak louder.
We went to the visitor center, the main visitor center, and asked where the dinosaur petroglyph might be located, because this is a huge area. And the lady told us there are no such things. And then a volunteer stepped in, which we assumed was a Christian woman, and she said, let me show you what you're looking for. And she took out a map and showed us exactly where to go. Well, there's 17 miles of trails in this place. So thank God that he put someone in that visitor center to let us know what was going on and where this was located, so we got to see it. Otherwise, we wouldn't have found it. There's no way we would have found it.
Yeah, but, 17 miles.
This is just another example of people back in this day and age, and I haven't even read the literature, so I'm not sure of the age of these petroglyphs here.
They said pyramid date.
Some B.C. time frame, but they always drew things. They knew what they were. It's like the Chinese New Year calendar that has all the animals they know, and there's 11 of them. We all know, and then they got the dragon on there, and oh, well, if they just made that one up. No, they actually saw dragons in those days, and that's what they called them back then, was dragons. So the Indians drew things that they saw and that they knew. They didn't come out here and just, you know, go crazy drawing animals that didn't exist. So, thank you, God, Yehovah, for letting us come out here and find this. We just more proof that the story told in Genesis about your creation and the flood is true.
But like Monty said, ask them about the dinosaur petroglyphs. They said there are no dinosaurs here, very sternly. So I said, I'm sorry, I meant the lizards, giant lizards. But it's a really neat area, as you can see up the mountain here. It was quite a ways up. This is all basalt, so it's obviously was active at one time, volcanic area. And off in the distance there, much bigger than this area. This is a residential area right here behind us, as you can see. And it's well worth coming on this Christmas Eve to prove once again, Scripture is always, always accurate. Shalom.